Hi, before I start showing you the shader, I want to clarify that this shader isn't mine. It was created by Mirza, Beig, and it's called the Animated Organic Look Shader. He shared the shader code, but it's not in HLSL, so you will need to convert it if you want to use it in Unity. I really like it, so I thought, let's see how I can make this work in my project. And I was somewhat successful, and even though I'm not a shader expert. Also, Mirza has some great assets in the asset store, so don't forget to check them out. First, go ahead and create a lead shader graph and name it whatever you want. I will call it Animated Organic. We have many properties to control everything we need. The organic properties are the most important ones because they are used for calculating the simulation. In the graph settings, I didn't change anything. I'm working on an HDRP project, but this should also work on URP and built-in render pipelines with shader graph installed. The material is set to lit because I wanted to interact with lighting. As I said, I didn't change any of the default settings. All of the calculations are processed in this custom shader. In shader graph, we can right-click and create a custom function. In this node, we can either use a string to put the function in a string mode, which I don't recommend in this case, or choose a file mode. In file mode, we need to use a source file in HLSL format. I have created this HLSL file, so let me put it in here. This is exactly what I have done with this custom function, as you can see. So if you want to make an HLSL file, you can right click and go to show in Explorer and make a text file, then change the format to HLSL. Now we can open this file and write our shader. I have created something called Organic Animated. Let's see what's inside. First, it has only one function or method, and it's called Animated Organic Underline Float. Remember that this underline float is essential in HLSL for Unity to understand certain assignments, which I won't go into detail about now. Just make sure to add underline float after your function name, then copy your function name and paste it into the custom node. The names must match exactly, as this is how the function will be called. Now this custom node has two other major components, inputs and outputs. Inputs are where we set some values, and outputs are where we get the results. We have two output parameters. First is output or result of our function, and the second one is color, which will give us random color that we will see how it works later on. Output is float and color is vector 4. So in the file, as you can see here, we have set some parameters. If you see carefully, the two last parameters have out before the type of the value. So this declares that these two, which are output and color, is used for our output in the custom node. The names and order must be exactly the same as those used in the parameters of our function. Also remember that vector 4 in shaders is called float 4. That's just shader language, which I won't dive into it. The other parameters are inputs. We have one boolean and several floats, along with one float 2, which is a vector 2. Again, create these inputs here with exactly the same names and in the same order. Please be careful with the order, as a slight misconfiguration will break the entire calculation. Click the plus button to set the name and type, and then adjust the order if needed. Now you can see why we created these properties here. It's all because we mapped these properties to these inputs, and we can change their values in the inspector. I have these float values and UV. Also, I don't need these three nodes, so let me delete them. The last property is time, which will control our animation movement. So I have created a time node and multiply it by speed to change the animation's movement speed. Inside the function, I use the exact calculations from Mirza's code with some minor tweaks to convert GLSL to HLSL and make it work well for Unity and our specific needs. I won't explain the code in detail, but I have added comments above each line to describe what each line does. If you are interested in understanding it, reading those comments will give you an overall idea of how it works. After the custom node, I added a branch, which is essentially an if statement to check if autocolor is turned on. If it is, it uses the custom node colors. If not, it uses the main color we set. Then I multiply that with our results or output, which our output is set in this line of our function. Next, I did some lerp between the fractal color and the main color. This step allows us to change the black area color to another color. The result of the lerp is connected to the base color, and then I multiply the results with brightness for emission. I also use the result from the lerp and input it into normal from height, which obviously generates a normal map from our results height. We also have a strength parameter to control the normal map's intensity, and we connect that to the normal. The only properties remaining are metallic and smoothness, which we can change in the inspector. And that's it for the shader. Create a material from this shader and assign it to your object. And voila, we have this well ugly beautiful thing. I'm not sure what to call it. I actually plan to use it in my game, so please don't steal it. Here we can control the speed and the main color of our material. The colors are HDR, so we can adjust their intensity. The fractal color controls the amount of black area or lets us change the color to something else. Organic strength controls the normal map from the height, creating a unique look. We also have metallic and smoothness. Next we have auto color, which automatically sets the color. We can change the scale. For scale multi-step, it's better to set it to 1.2. Most other values will break the shader. Then there is rotation, UV animation speed, and some ripples to give it a more lifelike look. There's a brightness to change the emission, and finally max iterations, which is the number of iterations our for loop will run. This value should be kept low because it affects performance. I highly recommend not setting it higher than 64. Let me set a slider to prevent exceeding this value. A lower value will give you less detail but run faster. The last thing to note is that this is a lit shader, so we can add some lights around it and see what happens. That's it for this shader. Don't forget to follow Mirza for his incredible work. You will find a lot of things that will leave you amazed. He's like a magic guy. I have put the shader graph and the HLSL shader file on my GitHub, so you can download the files from there. Don't forget to subscribe and like. It helps me create more videos like this one. Thanks, see you soon.